Yeah, I'm the hot friend now. I'm the hot friend. I don't know if this has happened to anybody. It looks like it's happened to you. I'm the hot friend now, which means I'm the most attractive friend in my group of friends. All right, fuck y'all. I don't like how y'all look at me. All right, no, I don't like that at all. Cause stop. All right. Cause half of y'all looked at me and y'all were like, oh, okay, I believe it. The other half were like, the fuck your friends look like? You right though, they're sitting in the back because there ain't no lights on them. I am a hot friend now. I wasn't always the hot friend though. It was a mantle that was passed down to me. I kind of feel like the Black Panther a little bit. My friend Thomas was the hot friend before me. Thomas is a 6'3", white Danish model looking boy. He looks like the white standard, you know? Like, you would find him in a Nazi magazine on a Sunday, you know? But I am the hot friend now because, I went to college, dropped some chubby pounds through working out, you know? I got some facial hair now, you can see it if you're close up. And I'm black, so I'm clean. Thank you, racial diversity, all right. But I got in an argument with Thomas the other day, because he was like, it's so much easier. He sounds like Donald Trump a little bit. He was like, it's so much easier for black guys to get white girls. And I was like, what? No, it is not. It is. 100%. Yeah, I don't even try. I was just mad because of the way he was saying it. Like, I didn't like the way he said it, because the way he said it, it's like, I'm not just walking down the street being like, hey, baby, what's going on? She's like, you wish. And I'm like, hey, slavery. And she's like, God damn it. Stacy, I have to. My grandpa used to own them. Some of y'all dealt with that. But yeah, it's easier for black guys to get white girls. But that's, you know, it's pretty simple. But it's like, you know, they just want us, you know? And you know why they want us, you know, for our really long, our really long lifespan, exactly. He's woke. We're gonna be around a while, black don't crack. But that's not entirely true, you know, Asian guys live longer than us, so they win in that. But like, we got bigger dicks, so. You win some, you lose some. It is easier for black guys to give white girls because we can give them something that white guys can never give them. What's that? Good dick? Some would say. Debt? Yes, a lot, actually. It's in both. It's in the back. Obamacare? Well, see, no one gets that anymore, but like, I got you. I got the hookup. But no, the one thing that black guys can give white girls that no one else can is mixed babies. Because mixed babies are better than all other babies. Obama was a mixed baby. I can give you the future president of the United States. Come on. All right. And it's like, okay, yes, other races can give you mixed babies, but not like us, you know? Being black is like being the black clothes in any laundry and any closet. Like, we go with everything, you know? Like, when you mix us with white people, we get presidents. You mix us with Puerto Rican people, you get fine-ass girls. You mix us with Asian people, you get, I don't really know. But, we don't see them a lot. Oh, Tiger Woods. Thanks, Dad. Yeah. I feel like a black and Asian family would be like the dopest family reunion ever. On one side of the backyard, you got fucking chow mein and shrimp fried rice and egg rolls. And on the other side, you got collard greens and domestic violence. And and fried chicken. And be cool. Oh, man. Hopefully I can come home after doing that one.